It's Madden NFL 24 on EA Sports. And the question is, are you ready for some football? It's the Buccaneers and the Lions coming up next.
The seating capacity is 65,000 at Ford Field, and we are right around that number today. A good crowd on hand and seemingly ready to go in the Motor City. Today we've got an intriguing NFC matchup lined up here, as it'll be the Tampa Bay Buccaneers taking on the Detroit Lions. Brandon Gaudin and Charles Davis on hand, kickoff just moments away. Charles, quickly, keys to the game.
For me, it's coaching. Who prepared his team the best going into this one to give them the confidence to believe that they would win the game? That's who's going to come out of this one on top.
The punter, Jack Fox, has us ready to go, and we are underway here at Ford Field. And he won't get this to the 20-yard line as he's down at the 19. So out come the Bucs now for their first drive. And bringing them out is the top pick in the 2018 draft, fiery competitor from Oklahoma, Baker Mayfield.
And he's a guy who plays with a lot of emotion. He's learned how to channel it really positively, because when he throws the football downfield and makes a big play, he'll be the first guy downfield to celebrate with you. But also, when his team needs that confidence, when they need that jolt, they turn to him, and he's ready to provide it.
They'll start the drive with a give to White. And he'll maneuver his way forward for about four. Second and six.
Brandon, we just saw the benefits of being able to run the ball successfully. They pick up 4 yards on that carry. So now, if you're a play caller, you can do just about anything you want. But on the defensive side of the ball, you scramble a little bit. Now you're behind trying to figure out, do I need to blitz him? Do I need to pressure him? How do I gain an advantage on this snap?
Give him four on the carry, and it'll make this a third and about two.
Back-to-back four-yard runs. Now, look, if they just do that all the way downfield, ball ends up in the end zone, but that's a little difficult to do.
Yeah, I think now third and two, that defense ready to stiffen up and stop that run. An early test, two plays in. This is third and two. They'll try to pick this up on the ground with White. And this is going to be a Bucs first down as he gets this up past the 30 to the 32. Faced with their first third down conversion opportunity and able to punch it through and pick it up on the ground.
And to me, doing it on the ground sends a different type of a message than throwing the football. And, you know, let's face it, we've done a lot of games together. How often have we seen third down turn into an automatic passing down, no matter what the yard is?
Yeah, and last thing you want, that opening drive to go three and out. You got everything scripted, lined up. Let's get some points on the board, and they're able to avoid that three and out. A big pickup there, 18 yards and a Buccaneer first.
That's a very nice game there, a confidence-building run. Love the execution up front, and the way you press the hole, absolutely perfect.
Mayfield now from the 50. Oh, his first throw of the game, going to be intercepted. It's the linebacker, Alex Anzalone. And the Lions are going to have great field position here as this is returned just shy of midfield. He's just got to be thinking, I hope that's not a harbinger of things to come. Very first pass of the afternoon picked.
And where do you go from here? Because when you start that way, do you allow that to seep into you and stay with you the rest of the game? Or do you find a way out of it? We're going to find out.
So here are the Lions now coming out for their opening drive. They're brought out by a former number one overall pick, coming off one of his best seasons ever in year 7 of his career, now in year 8, Jared Goff.
And at one point, the ascension of Jared Goff was really, really strong. Back-to-back Pro Bowls, took his team to the Super Bowl, and came really within one quarter of winning it. But since that time, he's had bouts of inconsistency, and that's been the struggle for him as he tries to get back to the form he showed earlier in his career.
Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete.
You know, every time we talk with people about the most important quality for a quarterback to have in the NFL, what do they usually cite?
Arm strength.
Yeah, and that's really way down on the list. Accuracy is one of the bigger ones, maybe the foremost one. That's what he needed on that play.
Now gone. That throw taken in by Jameson Williams. And they're well past midfield, just a yard or two shy of the 40. But Goff and Williams hooking up there for a Lions first.
But one of the ways that quarterbacks keep all the receivers alive in a play, never lock in on any one guy. Make sure you keep your eyes moving, scan the field. And here he finds the open guy for a nice pickup.
They will run for the first time with David Montgomery. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. 17 more yards on that one as they keep the drive rolling. I don't know what this says about me, but I love successful runs up the middle when the blocking is so well executed like that.
And it doesn't matter whether it's zone blocking, whether it's a power scheme, when you have a blocker on a defender, and then the running back can read it, find the proper hole, and just go, sometimes a thing of beauty.
Now a throw to the end zone on first down, but it winds up incomplete.
They are such a talented team at defending the perimeter and taking away throws to the outside. Great confidence, great skill.
Now a second and 10. They run, Montgomery. They'll get him to the ground at the 20 following a pickup of four.
That second down play call was not to pick up the first down. It was to accomplish what they did to get him into a manageable third down because they had incompletion on first down, so they were behind the sticks, so to speak. They needed to make up some ground, and they did.
Now a third and 6. A shotgun snap for Goff. Over the middle, complete. That's Reynolds. And he is going to have a Lions first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Really been an ideal start for them. They get the turnover on the opening possession. Now here they are moving the ball straight down the field on their first drive.
And that feels good, but you know on their side of the field, all they're thinking is finish this drive off because they took it away, right? So now you've got them back on their heels a little bit. Now go down, put a touchdown on them. Look out, you've won the mental battle early in the game, and that may carry over for you.
And he's going to be brought down just shy of the 5 at the 6.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent gain.
Now 2nd and 5, snap will come from the 6. Play action, it's Goff. And in for the Lions, touchdown! Shane Zylstra from 6 yards away. And the Lions take the early turnover and convert it into an opening touchdown.
This is why a lot of play callers love play action in this spot. You just want to freeze the linebackers just for a second. Then you got a chance to get a quick pass into your tight end right behind them for a touchdown.
Michael Badgley on for the extra point. It's up, it's good, and the Lions lead 7-0. So that drive in total 8 plays, and it's capped off by a touchdown for the Lions. Here are the Lions now as they line up and kick this one away. And he'll get it up just past the 20 as his guys will go to work at the 21-yard line. Tampa Bay, they're getting ready to set up shop here for their second drive. They threw an interception the first time they had the football, wound up leading to a touchdown the other way. How do you approach drive number two?
Going back to your game plan coming in, everyone has matchups that they like better than others, where they think they have an advantage. Dial up some of those plays. Try and go to those spots and get your offense moving.
They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. Toward the sideline, and look at that catch. Dragging the toes, and that's going to be a first down. Well done. 23 yards on the play. Well, maybe that'll help him settle back into a groove after the interception on the first drive here, picking up the first to start drive number two.
And it is just starting over, isn't it? Sometimes it's just how you have to do it. You have to erase things from your mind. Don't worry about what happened before, because over the course of a game, the good players, things turn out pretty well for them, and that's what he's trying to do here.
On first and 10, Mayfield. It's caught by Mike Evans. And that's good for a pickup of 10 yards. And that'll leave him with a second and just a few inches left. They go with White on the counter. And he'll go down shy of the 40 at the 41. 6 yards the pickup, and that's a first down. His first carry of their second drive, pretty solid. And, of course, remember back to their first drive, really strong throughout that one.
Not only is he getting good blocking up front, but how about his vision to find the holes? And he's seeing things before they even open and hurtling through them.
Mayfield on first down. Room to maneuver at the 35. And he's going to be out of bounds down around the 35-yard line. From the 35, back to work on second and four. Running out of the gun with White. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. It'll go down as a 2-yard loss, and it brings up a third down.
It always helps when you get great run support from your safeties, and when you get one who can actually read the play and get upfield and shut it down before it gets going. That's exactly what you're looking for.
Here is third and five. From the gun, Mayfield. And it'll find the open man. That's complete. And it's going to be another first down as they'll get him to the ground at the Lions 26. Give him 10 yards there as this offense is on a roll. This drive continues to plunge forward.
And that's how you shake off the interception you threw on the opening drive. Come back and throw another strike and gain nice yardage. And I give credit to two people on this one. The man throwing the ball and the person calling the plays. They're not shutting him down early in this game.
A first down throw for Mayfield. This is caught by Evans. And they will eventually get him down, but he's inside the five all the way to the three. Back-to-back receptions for him, and it's another first down.
Just picking up yardage in bunches here these last few plays. They have moved right down the field, and just like that, they're going to be set up with a first and goal.
White. Touchdown, Buccaneers. So, partner, was a passing game that drove them down the field, but when they get close, they trust that man in the backfield, and he took them home.
And they trust their offensive line as well, because so many of these units, they specialize in either pass protection or run blocking. This group shows its versatility and gets both done on this drive.
Chase McLaughlin on for the extra point. It's up and good. So these teams match touchdowns here in the first quarter, and we're tied 7-7.
Show him what you got.
So all even at seven now as they kick it away. Khalif Raymond now. And a good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line. Back onto the field come the Lions for their second overall drive. A good balance attack for that last touchdown drive they had. Now it's time to see if they can do that again.
And it really becomes a tale of two play callers, doesn't it? The offensive guy, he's in sync. Everything is working pretty well. For the defensive
guy, what's going on the defensive side?
That's a tough one because he's prepped all week as well, and he can't get a bead on exactly what they're doing right now. What he needs is one of his guys just to make a big play and disrupt things.
Now Goff on first down. And that is incomplete. Wow, the coverage a little too good there, and it's second down.
That's what you're going to need to do against those big receivers. You got to get in there and get physical with them. That time he got in close, got in tight, and knocked the ball away.
Second and 10. Goff now looks to throw. A little short pass here taken in by Laporta. They get six. That'll leave them with third and four. That's a staple of this offense. Drag route to the tight end.
Yeah, he's unable to use his size to break off much more yardage after the catch, but still an effective gain nonetheless.
Seven, seven, our score after one. Second quarter action now from Detroit, and it's the homestanding Lions who have the football. This now a third and four. As they've got it as we resume action. Now a third down throw, but it misses the target, incomplete.
Partner, we've got ourselves a ball game, and those guys on defense, they came to play. Slipped up on their first series, but they're definitely settling in now and letting it be known that points won't come so easy again.
Jack Fox out to punt here on fourth down. Back deep for the Bucs is Devin Tompkins. We'll call that a 43-yard punt, two on the return, and the Bucs will get ready to go on offense. The Tampa Bay offense set to go again. This drive here beginning probably with a pair of motivated groups. Remember, the offense scored a touchdown on their last time out, looking to repeat that in Charles's defense. They were very frustrated after giving up six the last time on the field.
And frankly, it's just a battle of wills in a lot of ways because you know they're both motivated. They both game plan for this drive, and they both have specific outcomes in mind. To me, it just comes down to who can execute better and which side can step up and assert its will over the other.
And now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete.
Had an open man that time, but ended up putting a little too much heat on it, don't you think, partner?
Absolutely. Just needed a touch more air under it. Instead, he fired an absolute bullet. Here's second and 10. Mayfield looks to throw. And the Lions pressure too strong. Down he goes. Flying in for that sack, Aiden Hutchinson.
Okay, I'm not sure you could actually draw a better pass rush than that one right there. Nowhere to go outside. He had to keep backing up and backing up and backing up. Eventually dropped for a huge loss.
A dime look defensively for the Lions on third. Working out of the gun, Mayfield. Throw left side complete. That's White. And they'll bring him down right around the 13. That's going to bring up fourth down, only a gain of two there.
I think that call was made not so much to try and get the first down, although they would have taken it if they could have gotten it, but to give their punter a little bit of space and try and help out their defense.
Yeah, got the safe completion on third. So they're forced to punt on fourth as this one's away. Taken right around the 44. That'll be a 41-yard punt, 4 yards there on the return, and the Lions will take over. Here's the Detroit offense now as they head back out onto the field. And Charles, a very uninspired effort the last time we saw them out there. It was a quick three and out, then they punted the football.
Yeah, and you never want to get stopped so soundly during a series, but what would be even worse now is letting it happen again right here. They've got to get going.
Goff and this Lions offense set for a first and 10.
Just shy of midfield at the 48. The play action fake. They'll look to throw.
That is caught by LaPorta. And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35. 16 yards right off the bat and a first down.
He's a rookie, and you don't want to get hung up on the word potential. But when you see him make catches like that, you keep thinking to yourself, he's good now. He's got a chance to be great with plenty of work.
First down, here's the run with Montgomery. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. They'll get a dozen there, and the Lions have a first down.
I think they like this drive a little bit better there, partner. Running game helping out, picking up some of the slack. Because remember, the last drive, they went three and out.
Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on first down. From the gun, here's Goff. Throw outside, caught by LaPorta. And they work this near the 5. He'll be stopped at the 6. A good gain again. That's now 31 yards combined on those last two plays.
Well, this is a defense that's definitely on their heels now because they gave up the running play for good yardage one play ago. Now the pass here sets this offense up first and goal. They're going to have to dig in strong now because they've been in retreat so far in this drive. This offense on the march.
Now Goff. And that went too far in front. He couldn't reel it in. It's incomplete.
Brandon, some of those windows that throw the football that exist when you're between the 20s, they don't exist when you're this close to the goal line. But as a former DB, I liked it closer to the goal line. Tighter windows made it easier to cover people, actually.
On second down, here's Goff. 5 yards that time on the completion, and now it's third and goal.
They kept the receiver in the short field, but that let his quarterback get the ball quickly to him before either guy in double coverage could react.
What a stand this would be if they can get the stop here. Third and goal. Goff throwing again. Open man, and he's got Williams. Touchdown, Lions. A great play there. There to make the grab. And the Lions have taken the lead. And down near the goal line here, they're able to throw it in.
And the key word, quick. Quick hitter out of his hands fast, into the receiver's hands even faster.
Badgley on for the extra point. And he's got it. It's now a 14-7 ball game. A drive that time of 6 plays. And it was Jamison Williams wrapping things up with a touchdown. Here are the Lions now as they line up and kick this one away. From the end zone, here's Devin Tompkins. And he'll be brought down shy of the 20, so the decision to bring it out of the end zone, not a good one. And Tampa Bay trots out there now. After that last score we just saw, now 14-7, so a chance to march down the field here, try to tie this football game. Now Mayfield and the Bucs come up on first and 10 at their own 18. They'll start here with a handoff to White. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
Well, that's just a pile of bodies there, and that's when you kind of find out who's a tough guy, right? Who can stand up and make a play? It's only a 3-yard run, but for both sides, they had to walk away from that field. I'm like, okay, I can stand up when the going gets tough in here.
From the 21, here's a 2nd and 7. They stay on the ground with White.
And he'll take this to about the 24, a gain of 3.
I do know from experience that when you slow down someone's running game, you're now doing the dictating on defense. And guess what? Now you're getting ready to tee off on their quarterback because they have to throw it all the time. But you still have to be alert for the draws and other plays of that nature to make sure you don't get hurt.
Mayfield. Work in the middle of the field, and he's got a man complete. And they'll get it all the way up about 5 yards shy of midfield. A good pickup there, 21 yards.
I don't care how many times we see it, I still get a kick out of watching quarterbacks and receivers do the pass tree in pregame warm-up. But I always remember that when we go to practices, we see that after practices as well. They really tune it up, don't they?
They tune it up. They know why they do it for these situations. First down.
And they build that trust, and that's why they're able to find him in this type of a situation.
First down, here's White. And no room that time, getting it to about the 46. That stop made by Jack Campbell.
No doubt about it. Really nice job there by the defense, not allowing him to get to the perimeter. But that means your defensive ends, your outside linebackers, the guys that you pay big money to sack the quarterback, they also have to have interest in the running game as well. And they did a nice job there of holding the point of attack and not giving ground.
And he'll do a nice job here just to fight his way back to the line of scrimmage. Officially, no gain on the play, and they're left with a 3rd and 8. Defensively, though, they had a chance there to hit him for a loss. Couldn't get it done.
Looked like someone was able to knife into the backfield, but he wasn't able to get him down. But his compatriots, they were able to grab him at the line of scrimmage and not let him get any further downfield.
On 3rd down, Mayfield. He had him. He was open, but he couldn't get it to him. It's incomplete.
1 1st down here, and that's all, folks. Good work by this defense to hold things in check and force a punting situation.
4th down, so Jake Camarda is out there. This is away, but boy, headed straight for the sidelines. And the punt over the side in the air, and the spot will be inside the 35. And Detroit back in possession of the football. And they'll just simply be looking to build off the confidence of the last time out where they scored a touchdown.
And confidence is powerful, isn't it? When you've scored once, you feel like you can go back out there and get it done again. Doesn't matter what the defense throws at them, they feel like they're in a groove right now, and they want to get out there and show it.
Yeah, hoping to stay in that groove here this go-around. On 1st down, it's good. Got his man complete over the middle. It's Reynolds. So the completion results there in 9 yards. And it'll bring up a 2nd and short. Out of the gun, Goff. He'll find Williams on the slant. And they'll get this down to around the 47-yard line. Catch number 4 for him on the afternoon, and it'll give him a 1st down.
That was a nicely run slant route, and what the receiver's trying to do is make the defender think he's going upfield for a deeper route and then breaks it off, usually after about 3 to 4 steps, and cuts towards the middle of the field. And now what he's trying to do is use his body to keep the defender away from the football and give the quarterback a really nice target.
Now a 1st down throw, gone. And that's hauled in by St. Brown over the middle. Only able to gain a couple there, and it'll be 2nd down. Here's Goff. Toward the sideline, and look at that catch. Dragging the toes, and that's going to be a 1st down. Well done. He got 29 yards that time.
The key here, as it usually is, protection. Love the design of this one because they leaked the running back out and sent him down the field. But you've got to give a quarterback time to locate him. They did for a nice play.
So from the 17 now, here's a 1st and 10. From the red zone now, Goff. They'll find Reynolds over the middle. Touchdown! Jared Goff with his third touchdown pass of the afternoon. And the Lions go up by two touchdowns.
Partner, remember that old film of Peyton Manning going through the route tree with his great receivers in Indianapolis? I think we're seeing the results of the same type of work here today. These guys know each other so well that they don't even have to call the play. They can just look each other and know the route that's going to be run, and usually the connection is perfect.
Extra point by Badgley, up and good. And it's now 21-7. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. From a yard or two deep, here comes a return. And he'll be brought down shy of the 20, so the decision to bring it out of the end zone, not a good one. And Tampa Bay trots out there now.
And Charles, we'll see what they can do here. Not a ton of time left, but enough certainly to get points out of this drive, and they need them right now because they're trailing.
Yeah, and this is exactly why you practice a two-minute drill all through camp and at least one practice each week before a game. A minute left, more than enough time to string a few completions together, reach the end zone, and then make that walk back to the locker room just a little more animated.
Meanwhile, Mayfield's throw complete there to Moore. And he gets it here to right around the 24 before he's out of bounds. They'll wind up getting 7 on the play, and that'll make it 2nd down.
Now, I believe they buzzed down. They're going to take another look at this play with all reviews coming from the replay official here in the final 2 minutes of the half. Did he keep those feet in bounds? That's the question they've got to decide. And I got to say, watching it in real time, it was awfully close.
Yeah, it certainly looked like a heck of a catch because he didn't appear to bobble it, which could complicate things. But even with the benefit of replay, that's pretty tight.
Well, here's the call. Second down and 3.
Mayfield now. Oh, everything falling apart now. Another one intercepted. And they are going to set up shop at the 32-yard line.
A few things better than a big man interception. You can always tell right when they get the football, there's that level of excitement and nervousness and also like, what the heck do I do with this thing?
And you say, no better sight? Well, not for the quarterback who just threw it. It's bad enough to throw a pick, but throw one to the big guy? But you're right about that. Now what do I do with it? But what's fun about it is, you know they're going to be in the film room after this ball game telling all their teammates, maybe I should shift over to offense. I've got skills. What do you think?
Oh, absolutely. I always find myself cheering for them after they intercept it. Unfortunately here, he couldn't make it into the end zone.
From the 32 now, here's 1st and 10. After the interception, here's Goff. And that one drops down incomplete. Good coverage there, forced the ball free, and it's 2nd down.
One thing you hope to see out of a rookie tight end is a real concentration when the ball's in the air, and I'm not sure that he didn't, but he has to be prepared for people making a play on it when that ball's up for grabs.
To throw on 2nd down is Goff, and his throw's going to be incomplete.
Well, they approached this drive with a lot of confidence after the last one ended up as a touchdown. But incompletions on their first two throws has them huddling up and trying to figure out a big play here on 3rd down to get their momentum going again.
The chance of wasting this great starting field position, a real threat. This is 3rd and long. Goff now to throw. And down he goes, a Buccaneer sack. Shaquille Barrett drops him for a loss of 10, and it's going to be 4th and long.
Traditionally, as a defense, your number one job, stop the run. But in today's football, it's impacting the opposing quarterback. Make him uncomfortable. And so far, they've not been able to do that.
Not at all. He's been really comfortable in the pocket. 3 touchdown passes already.
So that could be an important first sack if they do want to turn things around.
On fourth down, Jack Fox on to punt for Detroit.
And this will depend on the spot as it sails out of bounds. And they'll say it sailed out at the 10-yard line.
One more drive here for the Buccaneer offense in this first half.
And the ball backed way up. So thinking with this amount of time on the clock, probably just sit on it. And we'll see these two teams go to the lockers.
Yeah, I don't think you want to overthink it in this situation. Either side of the ball. Just go ahead and finish up the half and get on out and talk about it.
Clock at 20 seconds to go in the half as they come up first and 10. They'll indeed try to run it out as they start on the ground. And he'll just push his way forward for a few as the clock will run. Give him 3 on first down. It'll set up a 2nd and 7. So we've reached halftime here in Detroit with the Lions out on top. As we send you down to Orlando where Jonathan Coachman has our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach.
All right, Brandon, back to you too in just a bit. But first, welcome everyone to downtown Orlando and our EA Sports Halftime Report. In the first half, it was the veteran quarterback Jared Goff who had command of the offense. He threw a first quarter touchdown pass, then 2 more in the second quarter. A 3-touchdown half, and he may just be getting started.
All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number 3. The Lions in the lead, and they're going to get the football first as well as the second half is underway. This fielded right at the goal line. And he will make it to the 20-yard line and no further. And the Lions getting set to go on offense to start the third. As this offense takes the field to begin the opening drive of the second half, Charles, remember in that first half, good through the air and really all around an outstanding offensive performance.
Absolutely. They've reached the end zone several times. The passing game working awfully well. And most importantly, partner.
Yeah, they went to the tunnel with a lead. They come back out with that lead.
Absolutely. NFL coaches, we know they're perfectionists in a lot of ways, but they had to like what they saw in that first half.
And he's going to be taken down. Goff is sacked. Lavonte David making his presence felt in the backfield.
Well, partner, we know they came out of the locker room down on the scoreboard, but I will guarantee you, the defensive side of the ball got super emotional. They can come out and play with aggressiveness, with fury, because they don't have to be quite as precise, and it paid off for them on that play, didn't it?
Sure did. Excellent play, really setting the tone for this third quarter. And they need to work to at least get some of this yardage back after the sack. 2nd and 19. Goff now looking to throw.
This pass down the field for Gibbs.
And that will be incomplete. Trying to dial up the long way way out there, but it'll be 3rd down.
I know conventional wisdom says, hey, don't get it all back in one play. But sometimes you go ahead and try to. They tried to get it all back on that one. Weren't able to do so.
Now on 3rd and long, they'll look to throw.
Well, it's too early to figure out what kind of adjustments this defense made at halftime, but that's a good start to the second half. They cannot afford to give up more points and fall further behind, so well done to force the punting situation here.
Here comes the Lions punter now. As the drive goes backwards, so he's on to punt it away. And now a fair catch called for and taken just outside the 40-yard line. So possession goes over here on the punt.
And it will be 1st and 10 as they take over.
Good starting field position for them as they come up first and 10 at their own 43. They begin the drive on the ground. It's White. He pushes through a would-be tackler to get about 3 yards, second down.
Defenses always talk about earning the right to rush the passer on third down. And you know what offenses want? Win first down so that can set things up for themselves better.
And that wasn't helpful there. Not a big impact on first down.
From the 46, here's second down and 7.
Throwing, Mayfield. And his throw's going to be incomplete.
Certainly looked like someone was very confident in his ability to fit that one in. I would say he was overconfident because there wasn't a whole lot of separation there. Had that one covered pretty well downfield and knocked it away.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. To throw, Mayfield. And he bats it away and it falls down incomplete.
Zone coverage there, and they were playing deep. That makes it obviously a little bit harder to run by guys. And that time, it was not much of a window to get the ball in there, and it winds up incomplete.
Here comes the Buccaneers punter now, as he's on here to punt it away. He'll get off a fairly short kick here, as this is toward the sideline. And no return possible here as they angle this one out of bounds. And Detroit getting set to go now.
This crew had to punt last time they had the ball, but when you've got a lead like this, you content to play the field position game?
You are to an extent, especially if you like your defense, because you have the lead, you've been controlling the game. But why put them in a tougher spot? You want to get out there and get something done on offense and maybe take command of this game yourself.
Goff on first down.
Oh, first mistake for him in the ball game as it's intercepted.
Carlton Davis picks it, and they are going to set up shop at the 32-yard line.
So a potential momentum shifter there, working with a two-score lead third quarter, but that not the smartest of throws.
I would agree with you on that one because this game is still very much in the balance. It felt pretty one-sided to this point, but now if these guys can turn this turnover into points, things could start getting a little more interesting.
From the 32 now, here's first and 10. They'll go up the middle with White. And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. Second and right at a yard.
Good yardage there on first down. Exactly what you want. Get yourself set up to keep making first downs. Keep the clock running. And if they're smart, you're starting to milk the clock. No hurry before you run your second down play.
Second down and a yard.
Here's Mayfield. Under pressure, and he will go down. Sacked back at the 38.
Aleem McNeil, what an effort to get in there and drop it.
He's known for his legs and his fancy footwork. He's not getting much of a chance to use it here. The defense continued to hold the upper hand by bringing him down on that play.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. Mayfield to throw it.
And that is incomplete. But the pressure there on third down, forcing the errant pass. Fourth down coming up.
They certainly had good starting field position on that drive, but couldn't do anything with it after three plays. Have to admit that that's a disappointing end to excellent field position. When that drive started, they had 6 points that they were thinking about.
And that is no good. And this will remain a 2-touchdown game.
Yeah, 55 yards is anything but a gimme. You got to really concentrate on your leg swing and proper technique. This time, though, he's unable to convert.
Detroit's offense ready to take over. The last drive for this offense, Charles, you remember it ended in one play, that quick interception, but they do still have the lead as they start this drive here.
And that's something to focus on for them as well, because it's not quite no harm, no foul, but the interception, hey, shake it off, move on. Hasn't cost your team the lead, and now it's time to rebound. And the quarterback and his teammates, they can add to the lead with a good drive here.
Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8-yard gain, second and two.
Second and a couple.
Back to throw. Goff. Throwing quickly there, but it's incomplete. Not his best throw there, but where we sit right now in the third quarter, he's had a pretty good game throwing the football.
He certainly has, and it's not exactly at the point where we're doing 4-minute offense yet, but they've got to think about, I'm not going to say milking the clock, but understanding clock management here on out.
Third and two, Goff. He's got his target. That's complete. And he is going to have a Lions first down, and he was able to get it by plenty. A gain of 8 on third and three.
Got to say, I was a little surprised to see him, Charles, come out in the shotgun on third and less than a yard.
Yeah, but the way the NFL is nowadays, we hardly ever see anyone really run for it on short yardage. So they're going to throw the football more times than not. That was a nice, easy rhythm throw right there, and they pick up the first down.
To the air again. Goff. His throw incomplete.
We know it's not an easy job to go out and catch passes when people are trying to tackle you and knock the ball away. But the bottom line is, that's a pass he's got to have and a pass he should have caught.
So line of scrimmage, still the 39 on second and 10. Now it's gone. That's taken in, complete to Reynolds. 5 yards, now it's third and five. They'll need 5 on this play to move the sticks. To throw is Goff. And he is caught. And he's going to be out down inside the 20 at the 15. The Lions passing game in sync now. They've got another first down.
I'll tell you what, a lot of those mid-range throws have been available because sometimes teams get too concerned about the deep ball and they leave too much space in front of them. And these guys have been taking advantage so far.
The challenge flag is out. Todd Bowles not pleased with the ruling on the field, and he's going to ask the officials to take another look. Did he keep those feet in bounds? That's the question they've got to decide. And I got to say, watching it in real time, it was awfully close.
Yeah, it certainly looked like a heck of a catch because he didn't appear to bobble it, which could complicate things. But even with the benefit of replay, that's pretty tight.
Well, here's the call. So the challenge there does not go their way. This will indeed remain a completed pass. Line of scrimmage, the 15. It's first and 10.
Again, Goff. This to Laporta, right side. So give him 5 yards there on the pitch and catch, and it's second down.
I know sometimes we can get fooled when we watch him make catches, as we just saw him do there, because he really looks like a wide receiver the way he goes about his business.
Yeah, 230, 240 range.
Yeah, not super huge. Maybe not counted on to be that inline point of attack blocker that we used to have in the good old days. But you can flex him out. You can run wide receiver routes with him. You can make him a primary target. And that's how he'll shred a defense.
Call that a loss of a yard, and things get a little more difficult here, third and five.
Sometimes you just sit back and marvel at what he can do defensively. Speed, strength, quickness, he's the whole package. And that package just wrapped up the runner for a loss.
Now Goff. Oh, this will be incomplete. The rush gets home just as he was letting that go. That could have been worse. Instead, it's fourth down.
Smart move to throw that one away. You're in field goal range, so you definitely don't want to be loose with the ball. And that's great work by this defense to force a fourth down.
Badgley able to punch this one through. And they will open things up a bit more. It's 24-7.
And right now, Charles, this is about building that lead little by little, and they're able to do just that.
And it gets them past the key number of 16, so this is now a three-score lead. Not time to exhale just yet, but that might prove to be an important 3 points before things are said and done.
Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. Here's Devin Tompkins on the return. And he had no room to run as he's tackled down inside the 20. So out come the Bucks now. I kind of feel like they've reached a do-or-die point in this game, Charles. If they're going to try to pull off an impressive comeback, it has to start right here, right now.
Yeah, now they've got a final chance to get out of this situation, but they also understand they've got to move the ball and move it fast. In addition, they need to save as much time so they can get two more possessions.
They start to drive with White. And he fights forward for a modest 2-yard gain, second down.
I think they want to start getting back into this game, it behooves them to get better on first down.
Yeah, certainly not what they were looking for there out of the opening play of this drive. Here's a second and 8. Mayfield looks to throw. The pass is caught by Cade Otton. And he's got it past the 30 before he's hit and dropped. First down Tampa Bay there, a gain of 13.
Well, we talk all the time about playing situational football, and right now I think the scoreboard is dictating what they need to do. Where they are in this game, they've got to push the ball downfield, take their shots, try and get big chunks of yardage in a short amount of time. That was a nice play there.
He's going to sling this deep downfield. That's caught at the 25. A big play that time for Tampa Bay. 44 yards. Now look, you're not going to be able to get this all back at once, but that certainly helps.
So you're saying 3 yards in a cloud of dust, not the strategy?
I go aerial attack.
Yeah, I think that's what has to happen. And if you're going to run it, you need to break off big chunks. We just saw a big play right there. They need plenty of those.
So the big play gets them all the way down to the outskirts of the red zone here for first and 10. Now Mayfield. And his throw is incomplete.
At this point in the game and the situation they're in, partner, these incompletions that we're seeing, they need to turn into positive snaps, and soon.
So second and 10 now here in the third quarter from Detroit. They run straight ahead here with White, and he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. 2 yards the loss, and now third and 12.
That was well played there defensively. Two tight ends in the formation, which essentially gave him 7 blockers up front. Hard to imagine with all that size and beef that they could let a tackler through, but that's exactly what happened. A loss resulted.
On third down, Mayfield. Able to find the open man. That's complete. And they do get him down, but not before he's able to slip it inside the 5-yard line.
And this is an offense in need of getting a few good things to happen. Here's one right here. They've had their share of struggles in key moments, but that's a nice throw and nice work after the throw. And they're set up now with a first and goal.
First and goal, and they got to be thinking a chance to get right back into this football game. Mayfield. And in for the Buccaneers touchdown. Cade Otton from 4 yards out. And the Bucs are able to cut into this deficit here in the final minute of the third. There was no going through the progressions on that touchdown pass.
Yeah, nor was it necessary. His receiver won that route early, presented himself. No reason to wait. Go ahead and put it on him and score a touchdown.
McLaughlin for the extra point. It's up and good, so they claw back into it, 24-14 now. So that drives 7 plays in length. And Cade Otton caps things off with a touchdown grab.
following the touchdown. Here's McLaughlin to kick off. Here's Khalif Raymond to return. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here right at the 30-yard line. So holding will scratch off some of that return.
And I know fans get frustrated when they see penalties of this sort on kick returns, but it is difficult to do it right against these moving targets at full speed. Hard to do.
When the holding penalty sets them back inside the 20 as they get going on this drive. Now Goff on first down. This one swung out to Montgomery. That'll go for a gain of 7, and that's going to bring up second down.
Caught that look from you there, partner. I think we're on the same page on that one. Just his first catch, I think we both thought he'd be a little more active in the passing game. Let's see if that's the start of them trying to get the ball to him a little bit more here in the second half.
St. Brown in motion right. And they're going to give it to him on the jet sweep. And he'll be brought down on what's going to turn out to be the final play of this third quarter. We have played 3 quarters. We'll return with more after this. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Back now at Ford Field. It's the Lions holding onto the football, and they also have the lead as we start quarter number 4. Now a first down throw, Goff. He'll find Reynolds over the middle. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. First down, Lions on a pickup of 13.
Partner, I like that they're staying aggressive on offense because, to me, this drive is what is known as a put-away drive. You score here, that might put this one to bed. I like the fact that they're playing with confidence and not playing with fear.
The throw over the middle taken in. Call it a gain of 3 on the play. And that'll bring up second down.
They gave up the completion there, but this is what zone defenses count on. Catching the ball and not much run after the catch.
Here's 2nd and 7. Goff now looks to throw. Over the middle and taken in by LaPorta. They call his number again. It's his 6th catch and a first down.
I know exactly what's going to be said about that play from the defensive perspective.
What's that?
That's why I tell all you guys we need more than one tackler to the ball. He broke the first tackle. Luckily enough, there were more people there to get him down.
Now whistles and a flag down. Looked like one of the Lions linemen might have moved. Oh, jumping early from his tight end spot. Maybe trying to get a jump start on that route.
Yeah, I think you're exactly right about that. And oftentimes when you see that, that means the play call was supposed to come in his direction, and he was eager to go catch a pass.
Following the penalty, Montgomery. And he's able to get across midfield and down into Buccaneer territory. He'll get 3 of those penalty yards back here, leaving him with a 2nd and 12.
Brandon, I've got to think this offensive line has got some smiles on its faces. And I know it sounds crazy, but they practiced for this back in training camp. They knew they'd be in situations where it'd be extra defenders in the box coming after them, trying to keep them from locking down a game. Right now, they want to show the world they're up to the challenge.
He's got a man here. It's Montgomery. That one good for 26 and a first down. The passing game continues to be their friend. Even with a stable lead here in the 4th, Charles, they're going back to that well.
Yeah, with their overall philosophy, you know that they trust their quarterback. He's been able to throw it well. If they continue to throw these safe passes, who can blame them?
On the ground, it's Montgomery. And if there was a lane there, it closed up quickly as he stopped for no gain. 2nd down.
And Brandon, every running back wants to use their speed in order to get out in front of things. Sometimes you just have to be patient, let blocks develop. On that play, that didn't happen.
Here's 2nd and 10.
Let's go,
Now it's Goff off the bootleg. And he's going to go down. They sack him back right around the 30. Lavonte David able to get in there for his second sack of the afternoon.
And they visited the end zone frequently in this one, and obviously they wanted another one. But give credit to the defense there. They may not make the comeback, but pride showed. Good sack on that play.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. And this is going to be incomplete.
And this defense definitely in his head there on third down, and he's pretty fortunate. They didn't call for grounding on this one. That was a good 10 feet over everyone's head.
So here comes a very important kick now for Michael Badgley. He made his first, this from 47 yards out. Badgley able to knock this one through, and that will extend their lead even further. So that maybe not a knockout blow, but I suppose certainly every little bit helps when you're trying to salt one away in the fourth.
Well, the possibility of being beaten by two late touchdowns or at least sent to overtime does exist, but time, definitely a big factor at this stage of the game, is in their favor.
Here are the Lions now as they line up and kick this one away. From a couple yards deep, he'll bring it out of the end zone. And in hindsight, probably should have taken a knee as he only gets this out to the 16-yard line. And Tampa Bay trots out there now.
Well, certainly they'd rather have the scenario they had last time out, Charles. Remember, they had the short field. They took it in the end zone. Now this is going to have to be a longer, more sustained drive if they want to get points.
Yeah, a little bit more of a quick strike opportunity last time by where they were on the field, and you're exactly right about that. But now, backed up a little bit, what's that old expression we love to use? Time to matriculate the ball down the field and try and do it again.
On first and 10, Mayfield. He's got Otten. The completion, but they go in the wrong direction. A loss of yards, and now they're dealing with a second and long. Fourth quarter, every drive so critical, and you figure may only get one more shot after this, so a touchdown's imperative on this drive.
It is, but you also have to think to yourself in play calling, don't hold anything back. Don't save it for the second touchdown. You got the first one for the second one to even matter.
That flag accepted, and it backs the offense up a little bit. And that false start penalty certainly not helping their cause here. Second down and long. From the shotgun, it's Mayfield. Over the middle, he finds Godwin complete. That's a gain of 11. Would have been a first down if not for that penalty moments ago.
Well, he's had the interception woes in this one, Charles. And that time, a little bold to throw it into double coverage, but he beat the double coverage.
Yeah, but I admire that he still will challenge defenders downfield, even though the ball's been in jeopardy a few times in this game. A nice ball there against multiple defenders, and they advance it downfield.
He completes it to Evans. And he is going to have the Buccaneers first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
But correct me if I'm wrong, you know, you're down two scores. I don't think you need to rush just yet, but you can't take your time either.
Yeah, even if you don't want to commit to full two-minute offense, you have to up the tempo, up the urgency. Maybe you're starting to call two plays in a huddle each time you snap the ball.
Mayfield now looking to throw on first down. He finds his target. It's Evans. So the completion good for 7 there. And that will bring up second down. One thing I think that's safe to say defensively, the tackling's been really good.
And because of that, it's been very, very hard for them to move the ball because you're not getting the benefits of run after catch. They're tackling them almost on the spot. That means you have to run extra plays, harder to move it.
Second down, Mayfield. A quick throw there is incomplete.
A lot of times it's that first read that you have. Maybe you get it in pre-snap. He locked in on his target, but he was covered quite well, and that one's incomplete.
The Bucs on third down, 5 out of 9 thus far. Here it's 3rd and 3.
Here's Mayfield.
Pass taken in by his big tight end. And he is going to have a Bucs first down. They needed four. He doubled that. He wound up getting eight.
And in a two-score game, obviously, every play, every third down, like we saw there, magnified. Big pickup.
It was a huge pickup. What they really want, though, is to not even get to third down. They've got to maximize time and conserve as much as possible.
Mayfield's throw complete to Otten.
And that's good for a pickup of 10 yards. And they'll be left with a second and about a foot.
And there's a completion to the tight end. And look at the size of these players nowadays. At that spot, 6'4", 6'5", and up. A lot of guys used to be basketball players, somehow came back to football. And that's really good for the game of football. You're getting better athleticism, great hand-eye coordination, guys who know how to control their bodies when they run their routes.
Throwing again on second down, but this time it's incomplete.
I think he could have scanned downfield forever, but there wasn't anything available. Ends up throwing an incompletion, and I think he'll take that.
So offensively on this drive, 2-of-2 on third downs, and now they face a third and inches. They'll throw again. Here's Mayfield.
He's got his target. That's complete.
And it's going to be another first down as they'll get him to the ground at the Lions' 34-yard line. They give him 14 yards that time and a fresh set of downs.
That's the third time on this drive that these two have connected with each other. They've got a real rapport going. And right now, it's paying off with big chunks of yardage, as shown by that last play.
Meanwhile, Mayfield's throw on target to Godwin here.
And he takes this just a few yards shy of the red zone before going out. Clock management, definitely critical here if they want to get back in this game.
Absolutely agreed. They have to up the tempo in this case, down a couple of scores. Want to make sure they have a chance to win this ball game.
The time becoming a factor, down two scores, though they have two timeouts and, of course, the two-minute warning to work with as well.
Flushed out right. And he takes it down to the 10-yard line. 2 minutes left to play in this football game here on EA Sports. So it's Buccaneer football as we welcome you back. They've got a first and 10 as they search for a late score. Mayfield on first down. Touchdown! Trey Palmer from 10 yards out. And the Bucs go coast to coast and finish the drive off with 6 points.
I'm not sure win-win is the proper term here, but it certainly felt like it. They got the touchdown they needed. But if I'm on the defensive side of the ball, okay, you got the touchdown, but it sure took you a long time.
Yeah, because offensively there, you're probably hoping for a 1-to-5 play drive. That one ate up a little more time than they were hoping.
You're exactly right. And if you have that 1-to-5 play drive, you actually build up momentum and even more hope. When they had to slog their way downfield, they got the touchdown, but it's almost like,
yeah,
you know.
Doesn't feel right.
Exactly.
So just under 2 minutes to play, and this would figure to pretty much be your ball game right here. And the Lions are able to cover this one up. And now looking at the clock here, they do have two timeouts, but even if they force a three and out, they're going to have very little time remaining.
So that means they've got to be aggressive and find a way to knock the ball free. They've got to come up with it because they can't just rely, as you noted, on using their timeouts and getting the ball back. They might not have any time to mount an attack, even if they do play it that way. Get the football. That's their mantra.
Two hands on the football here as they run on first down.
Whistles now and a timeout. So defensively, they burn it here with 1:51 left.
Guys, you got this.
Another running situation on the doorstep as they come up second and 10.
He's going to get it again. Just looking to get forward and protect the ball. And he will have a Lions first down, and that's the one that should seal a victory.
And they'll indeed take a knee.
Second and 11 now.
Now we give running left with Montgomery. A short gain here, maybe a yard to the 29. Now we're going to get a timeout. Appears we've got an injured Buccaneer.
Well, now they're going to come out and take a look at this injury, and we'll be back in a moment.
And the Lions will take the knee here with victory in the cards. So on fourth down, out trots the kicker in a big spot here. This to perhaps salt this one away. Badgley's kick is good, and that will make this a 9-point lead. So barring something extraordinary here in the closing stages, that field goal should just about put this one on ice.
Yeah, we've got to find two scores, so, you know, we're not going to exactly move it over there yet. It can be done, but, boy, it's going to be a little bit of a stretch for them, isn't it?
Yeah, they would have to move incredibly quick and have some luck, too. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away.
And he won't quite make it to the 25. They'll come up first and 10 here. Here's Baker. And that one too wide and incomplete.
And now defensively in the two-minute drill, the big key to me, make sure you understand your assignments, and anytime you get a chance to tackle someone in bounds, get them on the ground.
One last shot for Mayfield here. And that will be incomplete as time has run out on this football game.
A higher scoring game, Charles, than we typically see in the National Football League, but fun to watch these offenses. They were really clicking. It seemed like everything that they dialed up worked.
Yeah, it certainly was fun to watch from our perspective. How'd you like to be those defensive coaches, though? That wasn't a blast for them at all. And let's face it, they all game plan, they all scout, they all think they're prepared. But executing and stopping teams, that's another matter entirely.
So that's a wrap for Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gunn, and this has been a presentation of the NFL on EA Sports. For more, check us out at easports.com. It's a win for the Lions as we say so long from Ford Field.